Hi guys, welcome back to another video of Easy Tutorials. And today in this video I will show you how to create a contact us page for HTML and CSS website. As you can see on my computer screen, we have one title and a small description at the top. Then we have two columns, and in the left column there is a contact form, and in the right column there are some contact information like email ID, phone number and address. You will learn to create this complete contact us page using HTML and CSS step by step in just 10 minutes. Before starting this video, please hit the like button and also subscribe Easy Tutorials YouTube channel to watch more videos like this one. Now let's start this video. First I have one folder here, and in this folder you can see I have two files, one is HTML file and one is CSS file. Now I will open my text editor, which is brackets editor. So this is our HTML file and this is the CSS file. I have written basic HTML structures and I have connected the HTML file with CSS with this line of code. Next we will write codes in body tag. Here I will create one div with the class name container, and in this container I will add one title in h1. So the title is connect with us. Next we'll add a small text in p tag. So this is the text. Now I will preview our web page. So just come back in the folder and open this HTML file with Google Chrome so that you can see this text in this web page. Now just come back in the CSS file. Here we will write body, and in the body I will add background. So we'll have different background color. Next we'll add the font size for the complete web page. It is 14 pixel. Reload the web page. Now you can see different background color. Let's come back in the HTML file and copy this class name container, and for this container we will set the width because the content is coming in the full width. So now I will change it to 80% and will add some margin 50 pixel and auto. Reload the web page and you can see we have some space from top and left side. Just come back in the HTML file, and after this p we will create one div with the class name contact box. Now in this div will create two other div. So first I will create the div with the class name contact left. Simply duplicate it and change it to contact right. So we'll have two different column. Now in the first one I'll add one title. So I'm using the h3 tag, and this is the title. Now we'll add one title in the right column also. So I'm using the same tag h3, and this is the title. So let's refresh the web page, and you can see these two titles right here in the left side. So we have to divide it into the two columns. So just copy the class name contact box, write it here in the CSS file, and for this one we will set the background, it will be white, and display flex. Reload the web page. Now you can see it is coming in same horizontal line. Now we have to add some space, so just come back and copy the class name contact left, write it here in the CSS file, and here we will write flex basis 60%, and we'll add some padding 40 pixel from top and bottom and 60 pixel from left and right side. Let's duplicate it and we will change the class name. It will be contact right, and in the right side width will be 40% and padding only 40 pixel from all side. And in the right side we'll change the background color. So here I'm adding background, it is this color, and color will be white. Save these changes, reload the web page. Now you can see two columns, and in the right column we have different background color. Now let me add some space in the above title. So here I'll write h1, and for this h1 I'll write margin from bottom. Next we'll add some space for p tag. So here I'll write the class name first, which is container, then p, and let's add this margin bottom here 40 pixel. Reload the web page. Now you can see some space below these text. Right now these text is not looking that good, so we'll come to the Google and search for Google fonts so that we can change the font of our web page. So open this website Google font, and here you can search any font. So let me select anyone, it is the popular font, so let's use this. Here you can select from this button, I'll select this also and this bold option. Click here on embed, copy this link and come back to the HTML file and add this link in the head tag. Now again come back to the font website, copy this and come back in the CSS file and add it into the body. That's it. Now refresh the web page and you can see different font family on our web page. Now we'll come back in the HTML file, and in the first column we'll create one form. For that, first we'll write the form tag, and in this form we will create one row. So here I'm creating one div with the class name input row, and in this input row we'll create input group class name. So we are creating div with the class name input group, and here we'll create one label. So in this label I'll write name, and after that we'll be adding a input field. So it is input, type will be text, and placeholder any name I can write here. That's it. Refresh the web page and you can see this label and this input field on this web page. Similarly, we will create other input field also. So come back in the HTML file, simply duplicate it, and here we will change the label and placeholder. Let's duplicate this complete row, and again we'll change the label here. It is email and placeholder. I'll write one demo email ID, and input type will be email. And next is subject, type will be text, and placeholder write any subject. Reload the web page and you can see four labels and four input field. Now we have to design it. So just come back in the HTML file and copy this class name input row. Use this class name in the CSS file. Here we'll write display flex, so that we'll get two columns. Next we'll add justify content space between and margin from the bottom. Reload the web page and you can see it is in two columns. Now let's copy this class name again, and after that we'll copy the class name input group. Write it here, and for this input group we will set the flex basis, so it will be 45%. Now just copy the input, write it here, and for this one we will set the width 100%. Reload the web page and now you can see it is looking better. Right now you can see when I click here you can see outline and there is border also. So just come back here, we'll write border none, and we'll add border from the bottom, 1 pixel solid, and this color. Outline will be none, and we'll add padding from the bottom. Reload the web page. Now it looked like this one. We can write anything in this input field. Now we'll come back in the HTML file, and after that we'll create one more input field, which is text area. Before that I'll write one label, and in this label I'll write message. Now we'll add one input field, which is text area. Remove this, and right now we have rows 10. Let's reload the web page, and you can see right now the input field height is large. So let's come back and we will reduce it. I'll write 5, reload the web page. Now it is looking good. Here we'll add one placeholder, and in this placeholder I'll write your message. Now we will copy this text area, write it here in the CSS file, and here we will set the width 100% and border 1 pixel solid and this color. Outline will be none, and we'll add padding 10 pixel. Reload the web page. Right now you can see this input box width is greater than the other fields. So come back in the CSS file, and here I will add box sizing border box. Reload the web page. Now you can see the width is fine. Right now you can see this label is touching this input field. So come back here, we'll copy this label, write it here in the CSS file, and for this one we'll set margin from the bottom and display block, and we'll change the color. Reload the web page. Now it looks good. So next we have to create one button to submit this form. So come back in the HTML file, and here we'll write button tag, and button type will be submit, and button text will be send. Reload the web page. You can see a button right here. Now we have to design this button. So come back in the CSS file, write button here, and for this one we'll add background and width will be 100 pixel, and we'll add border none, outline none, and color will be white. Let's reload the web page. Now you can see it is looking like this. Let me add some height, 35 pixel, and border radius will be 30 pixel so that you can see round border from left and right side. Next we'll add margin from the top, reload the web page, and now this button is looking good. Next we will add some shadow on this button. So come back in the CSS file, here we will add box shadow. Write this box shadow and just refresh the web page, and now you can see very light shadow for this button. Next I will add some design in the h3 tag, and will add some space at the bottom. So come back and copy this h3, write it here in the CSS file, and before that I'll write the class name, which is contact left. Here we will change the color and we'll change the font weight, and we'll add margin from the bottom. Reload the web page. Now you can see H3 color has been changed and there is some space from the bottom. Let's duplicate it, and here we'll change the class name contact right, and here we don't need to add any color, just leave these two code. Reload the web page. Now it looks good for the right side also. Now we'll add some content in the right side. So come back in the HTML file, and in the contact right column we'll add some content. So here we'll add one table. In this table we'll create tr table row, then td table data. In this table data we'll add email, and in the second data we'll add one email id. It is a demo email id. Let's duplicate it, so it will be the second row, phone number and one demo phone number. Let's duplicate it again, it will be third row, and here we'll add address and any demo address. Here I'm adding br to change the line. That's it, save these changes and refresh the web page. Now you can see these information in the right side. Next we have to add some space after this address. That means we have to add some space from the right side in the table data. So here we'll write tr and td, then first child. So it will be applicable only for the first data in the row. Here we will add padding from the right side. Reload the web page, and now you can see some space. Next we have to add some space from top also. So let's copy it again, write it here, and here we'll add padding from the top. Reload the web page. Now you can see good space from the top also. Now in this line we'll add one line break. So just come back in the HTML file, and here we'll add br. Reload the web page. And now you can see this complete web page looks very beautiful. So this is how you can easily create this type of contact us page using HTML and CSS by yourself. So I hope this video will be helpful for you. If you have any question, you can ask me in the comment section. Please don't forget to like and share this video, and also subscribe Easy Tutorials YouTube channel to watch more videos like this one. Thank you so much for watching this video.